Thank you, sirs. We humbly request our honorable chief guest, the former president of India, Bharat Ratna, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, to stir up the young minds with stimulating words.
இங்கு கூடியிருக்கும் எல்லா மாணவர்களே மாணவிகளே உங்கள் எல்லோருக்கும் என்னுடைய வணக்கம். நீங்கள் எல்லோரும் வெற்றியடைய வளமான வாழ்வு பெற ஒரு சிறு கவிதை மூலம் என் கருத்தை உங்களுடன் பகிர்ந்து கொள்ள விரும்புகிறேன். அந்த கவிதையின் தலைப்பு கேட்குதா எல்லாருக்கும்? கடைசியில் உள்ள கேட்குதா? கேட்கலையா? கேட்குதா? ஓகே. இந்த கவிதை மூலம் என் கருத்தை உங்களிடம் பகிர்ந்து கொள்ள விரும்புகிறேன். அந்த கவிதையின் தலைப்பு வாழ்வில் நான் பறந்து கொண்டே இருப்பேன். வாழ்வில் நான் இதை எல்லோரும் என்னுடன் சேர்ந்து சொல்வீர்களா? ரெடியா? சாப்பிடலையா? வாழ்வில் நான் பறந்து கொண்டே இருப்பேன். நான் பிறந்தேன் அரும்பெரும் சக்தியுடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் நற்பண்புகளுடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் கனவுடன். வளர்ந்தேன் நல்ல எண்ணங்களுடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் உயர் எண்ணங்களை செயல்படுத்த. நான் பிறந்தேன் ஆராய்ச்சி உள்ளத்துடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் நல்ல மன உறுதியுடன். நான் பிறந்தேன் ஆகாய உச்சியில் பறக்க. என்றும் பறந்து கொண்டே இருப்பேன். என் வாழ்வு முழுதுமே பறப்பதுதான். உங்கள் எல்லோருக்கும் என்னுடைய வாழ்த்துக்கள். சேர்மன் S.A. இன்ஜினியரிங் காலேஜ் சென்னை, சேர்மன் துரைசாமி சேர்மன் அவர்கள், பரந்தாமன் வைஸ் சேர்மன் அவர்கள், தசரதன் அவர்கள், ஸ்ரீ அமர்நாத் அவர்கள், கோபிநாத் ஜாயிண்ட் செக்ரட்டரி அவர்கள், டி சபரிநாத் கரஸ்பாண்டன்ட் அவர்கள், ஸ்ரீ வெங்கடேஷ் ராஜா அவர்கள், சுயம்பழகன், அருமையான பேர் சுயம்பழகன், உங்கள் பிரின்சிபல், எல்லா ஆசிரியர்கள், டீச்சர்ஸு, மாணவர்கள், மாணவிகள் எல்லோருக்கும் என்னுடைய வணக்கம். உங்களையெல்லாம் பார்க்கும் பொழுது ஒரு சைடில் மாணவிகள் நல்லா ஒரு கர்டன் போட்டிருக்காங்க, இன்னொரு சைடில் மாணவர்கள். நீங்கள் எல்லாரும் வருங்கால இன்ஜினியர் இல்லையா? வருங்கால இன்ஜினியர்கள் இந்த S.A. இன்ஜினியரிங் காலேஜ் வருங்கால இன்ஜினியர்களை எவ்வாறு அந்த இன்ஜினியர்கள் எம்ப்ளாயபிலிட்டி எவ்வளவு இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் அப்படின்னு பார்க்கணும். எம்ப்ளாயபிலிட்டி, நீங்கள்லாம் படிச்சுட்டு இங்கேருந்து போகும்போது எத்தனை பேர் வேலை செய்ய போகிறீங்க? பணி தேடி செல்வீர்கள் எத்தனை பேர்? எல்லாருமா? இல்லாட்டா பணியே உண்டு பண்ணி வேலையை, யூ வில் கிரியேட் ஜாப் ஃபார் யூ, தட் மீன்ஸ் என்டர்பிரனர்ஸ். ஹவு மெனி ஆஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு பிகம் என்டர்பிரனர்ஸ்? ஹவு மெனி ஆஃப் யூ வாண்ட் டு பிகம் சீக்கர்ஸ் ஆஃப் த எம்ப்ளாய்மெண்ட்? தேர் ஆர் டூ கேட்டகரி. அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட்? அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் ஆர் நோ? ஒன்று சீக்கர்ஸ் ஆஃப் எம்ப்ளாய்மெண்ட், அஸ் சூன் அஸ் டிகிரி வந்த உடனே எம்ப்ளாய்மெண்ட் எங்கே இருக்குன்னு பார்க்கணும் இல்லையா? அதான இப்போ நேச்சுரல் வே. Another way is, I create employment for me. I become an entrepreneur, I employ a number of people. A group of engineers join together, start an enterprise. They employ hundreds of engineers, hundreds of workers, hundreds of staff. I am sure S.A. Engineering College management and teachers, they all make you all employable. Enna sir, pandringala? Pandringala? Unga principal solraaru pandrom digirar. So, ungal ellorku vaaltukal. நண்பர்களே, நீங்கள் எல்லோரும் என்னோட சேர்ந்து சொல்கிறீங்களா? மே ஐ பி எ ப்ரொடெக்டர் ஆஃப் தோஸ் வித்தவுட் ஒன், எ கைடு ஃபார் ஆல் டிராவலர்ஸ் ஆன் தி வே, மே ஐ பி எ பிரிட்ஜ், எ போட் அண்ட் எ ஷிப் ஃபார் ஆல் who wish to cross the water. Friends, this was said in the 8th century, nearly 1300 years back, by Acharya Sandideva. Acharya Sandideva said, may be a protector for those without one, a guide for all travelers on the way, and may be a bridge, a boat and a ship for all who wish to cross. When I see thousands of engineers in this campus, I visualize all of you will be a protector, all of you will be the guide, all of you will be a bridge, all of you a boat, and all of you a ship for all who wish to cross the water. May God bless you all. Friends, I am indeed delighted to visit S.A. Engineering College and address and interact with the students. Already I have interacted, and faculty. My greetings to the management, principal, faculty, staff of the college. When I am with you, I would like to share my thoughts on education. In particularly engineering education. When I with you, I would like to share my thoughts on the topic technology and its multiple phases. What the topic am I going to talk to you? Very good. Technology and multiple phases. Let me highlight to the young students, particularly there is a line marked student from here, teachers, and VIPs that side, and student this side, okay? So I am addressing the students now. So let me highlight the young students. What will be the type of leadership will be needed in future when you go out of this college with a combination of technology and management? Fortunately, your campus teaches technology and management. Now hear me what I'm saying. Very closely you must hear all the young fellows, because I'm going to ask questions. Okay? Yes or no? Dear friends, I was studying a book. Name of the book, Empires of the Mind. Empires of the Mind by Dennis Whiteley. How many of you read Empires of the Mind? It's a small book. It's a paperback. About 5 years back it has come. Empires of the Mind. This book, Empires of the Mind, gives what type of new world which we are facing now. What was yesterday, what is today? I have modified certain points of the author to suit the occasion today. I have also added a third line which relates to another action of a leadership. The book message is, the message of the book is, what worked yesterday won't work today. What the message? That's the topic. Okay. Now, it's a combination of technology plus leadership. What worked yesterday won't work today. So I'm going to give you an example. Role of leadership, knowledge society. We are entering into a knowledge society. Now, yesterday, natural resources defined the power. Yesterday, natural resources defined the power. Today, can you imagine today? Today, for example, yesterday, natural resources defined power, Singapore. They don't have a natural resource. America has got natural resources, India has got natural resources. But yesterday, natural resources defined the power. Today, knowledge is the power. See the difference? Yesterday, natural resources defined the power. Today, knowledge is the power. Example, Japan and Singapore, they don't have any resource. But they use knowledge. They do the system engineering. They make products. They use for their country and market throughout the world. Like our IT fellows here in India, $100 billion business they do by knowledge. Second point, yesterday, hierarchy was the model. Yesterday, hierarchy was the model. Boss, second boss, third boss, fourth boss. Today, synergy is the mandate. People have to work together. Institution will be enabler for intersection of the multiple faculties toward the mission and goals. Third point, yesterday, leaders commanded and controlled. Leaders is a commanded and controlled. Today, can you guess? Today, leaders empower and coach. When you go to this campus, when you get an employment as a manager or a group of people, it is not your job is commanding and controlling. Your mission is a leader, empowers and coach. You have become a leader and coach. This side, smarter side. Coach, they say. Okay? Now, that means institution like SA will enrich itself through exposure to the needs of the sustainable development. Fourth point. Yesterday, shareholders came first. You know, today, customers come first. That means institutions should inculcate sensitivity to the needs of the stakeholders. Yesterday, employee took orders in a workshop or in a working place or a design center. Yesterday, employees took order. Today, can you guess? Team make the decision. Today, team makes the decision. That means institutions will promote team spirit. Instead of separating civil engineering, mechanic engineering, electronics engineering, and there'll be a cross-fertilization. Yesterday, seniority signifies status, boss. Yesterday, seniority signifies status. Today, creativity drives status. You may be 20th boy or girl. If he is creative, if she is creative, doesn't matter whether 60-year senior man is there or 70-year senior man is there or 80-year senior man is there. Creativity decides your worth. Okay? You follow? Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge. Knowledge makes you great. Now, yesterday, production determined availability. Today, competitiveness is the key. Yesterday, value was extra. Today, value is everything. Institution will have the priority to inculcate the value addition to every level. When you go out of this college, you have to go as a great human being. Not only as a great engineer, great human being. That means you are a man or woman of a value system. You will do? Will you? With value system, you will go out of this campus. That depends on your teacher. I had a teacher. His name is Sivasubramani Subramani Iyer. British India, 1941. I was a 10-year boy. I was studying fifth class. My teacher, Sivasubramani Iyer, enters the classroom. When he enters the classroom, he radiates knowledge. He's a learned man. He's a Sanskrit scholar, Tamil scholar. He's radiating knowledge. When his teacher entered the classroom, he radiates purity of life. Purity of life. That is, when a teacher enters the classroom, purity of life comes from the Gandhian life, what he led at home, in the laboratory, in the science laboratory, in the school. So teacher, what more you want a syllabus? I felt on the, when you're 10th, fifth class, when I was studying 10-year boy, I felt I got all the syllabus with my teacher. A purity of life and knowledge, embodiment of knowledge. So friend, yesterday value was extra, this eighth point. Today value is everything. In addition, we have the priority to inculcate the value addition every level. Yesterday, everyone competitor, today everyone is customer. Now the most important thing, yesterday profits were earned through expediency. Today work with integrity and succeed with integrity. That means in 21st century, all you engineers, both sides with curtain, this side and that side, when you go to this campus, repeat with me, I will. You have not eaten 3 days. I will. Work with integrity. And succeed with integrity. Very difficult second part of it. Succeed with integrity. But that's a challenge. That's a challenge. So 21st century engineers, technologies, when you enter into India or any country, remember, you will have a responsibility to work with integrity and succeed with integrity. So friends, I am thinking what now the institutions like what you are all studying have to imbibe the concept of work with integrity and succeed with integrity. Management, the leaders should be like that. And act as promoters of such culture in their students. Now I am thinking, what drives the culture of excellence? I was asking myself, what drives the culture of excellence? Culture of excellence is driven by innovation and creativity. Now what is innovation? Innovation, a nation's economic development, India's development, is powered by competitiveness. Competitiveness is powered by knowledge. Knowledge is powered by technology, that's what you are specialized. Knowledge is powered by technology. Technology is powered by, can you imagine, technology powered by innovation. Technology innovation is powered by resource investment. Otherwise, you'll be inside a cupboard. We need resource, technology to come up, innovation to come up. Innovation opens up new vistas of knowledge and new dimension of our imagination to make everyday life more meaningful, richer in depth and content. Innovation now is born out of creativity. What is creativity? In a knowledge society, what we are today, we have to be in knowledge society, 21st century, we have to make innovations continuously. Innovation comes through creativity. Creativity comes from beautiful minds. It can be anywhere, any part of the world. It may start from a fisherman hamlet, or a farmer's household, or a dairy farm, or a cattle breeding center, or it could emanate from a classroom, laboratories or industries or R&D centers. Creativity has multiple dimensions, like inventions, discoveries, and innovations. Creative mind has the ability to imagine or invent something new, combining, changing, or reapplying existing ideas. Creative person has an attitude to accept change and the newness, a willingness to play with ideas and possibilities, a flexibility of outlook, the habit of enjoying the good or looking for always improve it. Creativity is the process through which we can continuously improve ideas and find unique solution by making gradual alteration, refinement to our work. The important aspect of creativity is seeing the same thing as everybody else, but thinking of something different. Innovation and creativity ultimately result into culture of excellence. Just now we saw what is innovation, what is creativity. Now, the both of them lead to culture of excellence. Now, when you are studying in this engineering college, S.A. Engineering College, what you are studying? Everyone should aim. Suppose you see this light? See this light? Look up, not look down, look up. When you look up, you see the bulb, you see the light. Whom do you remember? So say boldly. Thomas Alva Edison was a 9-year boy in New York. He was using the oil lamp. That 9-year boy said, I will electrify whole of New York. Faraday's law came before Thomas Alva Edison. But it was a law, Faraday law, how to create the electricity. He is the discoverer of electricity, Faraday. But Thomas Alva Edison said, for him it has become Bible. 2 volumes Faraday wrote about how to generate electricity. He wrote those book, he studied the book, he didn't go to school. He did not have money to go to school in those days. Thomas Alva Edison did not go to college, did not go to engineering college. But he read that volume 1, volume 2 of Faraday. Faraday, the inventor of the electricity. That book transformed Thomas Alva Edison to discovering, inventing this one. Which one? Application of electricity. The whole world has been electrified. Question is, whether you want to be unique. You know? Why? When the telephone bell rings, whom do you remember? Alexander? Graham Bell. Now you have got number of cell telephone. But that Alexander Graham Bell discovered the device because he cannot communicate with his mother. His mother was deaf. So he wanted a device, a loud device that turned into a telephone. So they are all remembered, isn't it? They are all remembered. And then, when the aircraft flies, you remember the 2 brothers. And that 1 lady who got 2 Nobel Prizes in the world. Can you imagine who is that lady? Madame Curie discovered radium. And also application of radium for cancer cure. For that she got 2nd Nobel Prize. So we remember all of them. The question is whether you want to be remembered. Whether each one of you want to be remembered. Don't go near the people when they say it cannot be done. Don't go near them. Everything possible. Whatever you say impossible, it has been made possible. For all this, what we need is excellence. Whatever work you do, when you read thermodynamics, when you read three laws of Newton's or Einstein's theory of gravity, when you read, remember, always, all these great minds worked on the excellence. What is excellence? What is the culture of excellence? Excellence in thinking and action is the foundation for any mission. What is excellence? Friends, you all belong to the youth community. We should stand for a culture of excellence. Moreover, excellence not by accident. It's a process where an individual, organization or nation continually strives to better oneself. The performance standards set by themselves, they work on their dreams with focus and prepare to take calculated risks and do not be deterred by failures, and they move towards their dreams. Then they step up their dreams. As they tend to reach the original targets, they strive to work to their potential. In the process, they increase their performance, thereby multiplying further their potential. This is an unending life cycle of phenomena. They are not in competition with anyone else but themselves. That is the culture of excellence. I am sure each one of you will aspire. Each one of you are this side or that side. Each one of you will aspire. Aspire to be a unique person with a culture of excellence. I gave you the names of unique people, we remember. Now, friends, I want to conclude with my lecture with one experience. Same city it happened. Long, long ago, you are not born, not you are not even idea form. 1954 to 57. 54 to 57, none of you are an idea form. Okay. 54 to 57, I was studying here. Madras Institute of Technology. There I had a very interesting professor, very tough professor. I don't know whether your professors are tough. I had a very tough professor. And there is one Professor Srinivasan. He is an aircraft designer from Calta. He was teaching, designing the aircraft structure. Third year he called all the students, 9 students. In those days, only seat were 9 for aeronautics. 9 including me. He said, you guys, in 4 months' time, you have to design a low-level attack aircraft. A low-level attack aircraft, Mach number 2, twice the sound speed, Mach number 2. And I don't know how he did. On that day I had a blue shirt, and my professor likes blue shirt, so he named me as a project chief for that. So 8 students, I am the project chief. In 4 months, we have to make low-level attack aircraft. Do you have such type of a project? You must have. That project needs propulsion, aerodynamics, structures, material, and integration, system engineering, and all area of science and guidance and control, every area needed. We 9 of us started working because Professor Desant is a top professor. If you don't do, you will create problem. So we start working hard. In those days, I didn't have a computer. 1954, computer Madras has not seen, you know. And we are using slide rule. Have you heard about? It's in museum now, slide rule. So with slide rule, only we use clacks table and slide rule, we started designing, and a big drawing board. Today in computer, you can design drawing cells. So in those days like that, we worked very hard. But Madras, you know, Madras, Saturday, Sunday, many of my friends, and they'll be missing. They'll be in the beach or the cinema houses. That's a problem. But anyway, that you have to accept. But you are all good guys. You are all good guys. Can I take it? No. TV, you are TV fellows. So we worked hard. Exactly third month my teacher came, my professor came and reviewed whatever we have done, whatever drawings, whatever calculation seen. He said hopeless output. Okay. When a professor says you have done a hopeless nine fellows, done a hopeless output, really shocking. And not only that, he says you are the leader. He told me, you are the leader of the team. I was getting a scholarship. You will lose the scholarship if another 1 month time you guys don't put all your efforts to design of a low-level attack aircraft. So we worked very hard. Okay, that 1 month, really many months, and many Saturdays, Sundays, all days we worked. Exactly, my brother was, my professor was going for tennis court on Sunday, last week of the commandment day, and he entered my lab and saw our work. All of us were sitting there on Sunday working, all of us were sitting, uni work like that. So he was very happy, these fellows are working. He went through our calculation, went through our drawings, went through all our activities, what we have done for the last 1 month, 4 months work we have seen, and he said, fantastic work you guys have done, he said. That's okay. Fantastic work, the professor certified you, so you are happy, I am also happy. But important thing, what happened, he took us his home, he was good Madras, good coffee he gave, and all the things he gave us in his house. So we are all very happy. But what I want to convey to you, what our 9 students learned, they are all successful people today throughout the country. What we learned was system design, system integration, system management. During our engineering study, bringing together multiple engineering, multiple technology, we learned what is called system design, system engineering, and system management. This is the message I want to convey to all of you. This is very important. We have to, when you are in the engineering college, don't get compartmentalized. Electronics, mechanical engineering, like that, electronics engineering. But there are, wherever you go, your employer is going to ask, design a product you can't do with only electronics or only mechanical engineering. You need multiple technologies. Understood? Not understood? That's very important. Now I'm going to talk to you. What's going to happen? Next 10 years time, when you go in the market, when you are all as great engineers, technologists, and managers, when you are in different places, I am going to tell you something going to happen. The information technology and communication technology, as you know, already converged, leading to information communication technology, ICT it is called. Information technology combined with the biotechnology has led to bioinformatics. Similarly, photon is grown out of the lab to converge into classical electronics as microelectronics. Now, the nanotechnology has come in. It is the field of the future that will replace microelectronics, according to me, and many fields with tremendous application potential in the areas of medicine, electronic material science. Now hear me carefully, when nanotechnology and ICT, that is ICT means information and communication technology meet, when nanotechnology and ICT meet, integrated silicon electronics, photonics are born. It can be said that material convergence will happen. With material convergence and biotechnology linked, a new science called intelligent bioscience will be born, which will lead to a disease-free, happy, and more intelligent human habitat with the longevity and high human capacities. Convergence of bio, nano, info technologies can lead to the development of nanorobots. Now, when nanorobots are injected into the patient, my expert friends say it will diagnose and deliver the treatment exclusively in the affected area, then the nanorobot gets digested as it is a DNA-based product. I saw the product sample in one of the laboratories in the South Korea, where the best minds with the multiple technology work with the target of finding out out-of-box solution. Now friends, I thought of sharing the next aspect of the problem. Next aspect is, I want to tell you, I have, in the last 10 years, met more than about 5 million university students and faculty from more than 150 universities in India and 50 universities abroad. Based on this aspect, I wish to formulate a vision of 21st century institute of national importance. How all the institutes in India, engineering institutions, have to change. Number one, institution have to prepare citizens for the future with a global outlook and capable of serving his or her nation or nation has choice. Second one, science, technology, and public policy are interrelated for mutual benefit and ushering in humankind's development. This link has to be solidly built in the university education. Good teachers can be any part of the world. The institution has to bring in the resource through innovative content generation in the virtual classroom. I visualize your institution SA will have a lot of virtual classroom, so the best teachers, lectures you will hear. Technology connectivity among universities and institutions have to be pursued on a war footing using cost-effective virtual classrooms. With the world population increasing and resource dwindling, the mindset has to be developed for conserving and sharing the resources. Look for a new research for abundant resources. This calls for a noble spirit as well as the research spirit. You must all have a research spirit. In summary, 21st century, in the present century where you are, so 21st century national level institution education about developing enlightened citizenship for a knowledge society, for peace and prosperity of the nation and the world. I have detected certain dynamics. Wherever there is a research intensity, I have seen that. Wherever there is a research intensity, it has enhanced the quality of teaching. And also institution got great name in the world of teaching. Universities and institutions from the developed world with their vast experience of a century have realized the significance of research as the foundation for the university or institution. Third dimension is that sharp gradient and the accelerated development process can be give a platform for research for sustainable development. Now friends, hence we should see how we can empower them, all of you, through university to university collaboration, student-faculty interaction lab, lab-to-lab collaboration, reaching out the world-class quality teaching and research through virtual reality environment with the excellent content generation. So in conclusion, friends, finally, I'm going to ask you, both girl student this side and also boy student this side, what you like to be remembered for? The question is, what you like to be remembered for? I told you two examples. The bulb, you see, you remember whom? Thomas Alva Edison. Telephone, whom do you remember? And also number theory, whom do you remember? Number theory, he belonged to Madras, Kumbakonam. Srinivasa Ramanuja, okay? So they're all unique people. So if you want to unique, you should go and write today in your computer, on your notebook, you write what I will be remembered for. one page you write, that page may be a very important page in the book of human history. And you'll be remembered for creating that one page in the history of the nation, whether that is a page of invention, the page of innovation, or the page of discovery, or the page of creating a societal change, or a page of removing the poverty, or the page of finding new technologies in energy and astronomy. I will be happy if you could write this page and mail to me, apj@abdulkalam.com. My mail is apj@abdulkalam.com. What I will be remembered for, if you guys write, young fellows, if your thoughts are very good, I will correspond with you. I'll send you some good books also, okay? With these words, I once again congratulate all the students and my best wishes to faculty members and professors for success in their mission of creating enlightened citizens towards building a knowledge society. Most importantly, creating employable technologies and engineers. Employable engineers, technologies. May God bless you all, friends. Now, you want to ask me some questions? I don't know whether you have questions, but I have something for you. I have got 8-point vote for graduate, for students, okay? For engineering students, 8-point vote. Ready? Ready? You can sit down and then take the oath, okay? And carry out also. If you don't carry out, I'll catch you. Now, first one, engineering. Engineer, you've not eaten for 3 days. I think I asked your management to feed you. Engineering. Engineering and technology.
Engineering
and technology. Is a lifetime mission for me. I'll work,
I'll work,
and succeed.
Wherever I am,
your thought will always come to my mind.
That is,
what process or product I can innovate, invent, or discover.
I realize, I have.
Set a great
technological goal
that will lead me
to think high,
and work,
and
persevere,
realize the goal.
My greatest friends,
my greatest friends
will be great
scientific,
technological minds,
great teachers.
On great books.
I firmly believe
no problem
can defeat me.
Repeat with me.
I firmly believe
no problem
can defeat me.
I'll become
captain of the problem,
defeat the problem,
and succeed.
Will you?
Yes.
I will work.
Work
for removing
the problems
faced by planet Earth
in the areas of
water,
energy,
habitat,
waste management,
and the environment
through the application of
science and technology.
My
national flag
flies
in my heart.
I will bring
glory to my nation.
Thank you, friends. Thank you.
Now, friends, this side, 2 questions. Girl side, 2 questions. Boy side, student. Only student can ask questions. Okay? Okay? Who will start this side? If you don't see it, all the 4 questions will be transferred there. Anybody want to ask questions? No question. Girl said no. Yes. Speak loud. No, that's it. That girl got up first. Mike, transfer the mic, then it will come to you. You stand. Stand.
The development of science and technology is high in other countries compared to our country. Why?
Well, I don't know whether other countries, everywhere, some area, there are certain very good progress. For example, proteomics is a very important field. One nation cannot do. Multiple nations jointly, they are doing proteomics, okay? And India in the bioscience, biotechnology has got a good base. For example, India is self-sufficient food, okay? We produce 250 million tons of food, 250 to 60 million. That means agriculture science, agriculture technology, we are equally good. Of course, we know how to deploy it, how to value addition, we have to learn from a lot from others, okay? Okay. Next question.
Good evening.
Said you ready for two fellows? Yes.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Will technology replace teachers?
Eh?
Will technology replace teachers?
Replace?
Teachers.
Well, no, never. Never. Okay. What class you are studying?
First year EC.
Electronic communication. Now tell me, now what is your dream after EC degree you get, then what?
To be a good person and a complete engineer. To be a good
You guys person. Silent Ajay?
To be a good person and a complete engineer.
Very good. Good luck for you, okay? See, teacher, for example, I told you my teacher, Siva Subramani Iyer. When he went to a classroom one day, he taught me how a birds fly. Put a blackboard, put a sketch of a bird, put wings, tail, and started explaining how a bird fly. Then took us the seashore, saw seagulls fly. The day he taught me, the way he taught me, I knew what would be my career. Even though I was 10-year boy, he injected me what should be my life. Okay? Teacher only can do, computer cannot do. But you can make computer. You can make computer working. Okay? Computer, you can create a computer. Okay? But computer cannot create you. Okay? That side, boys' side. Smart question from girls' side.
Good evening, sir.
Yes, where are you?
Sir.
Where are you?
I am here, sir. Can you see me?
You run here. Sit down. You guys, sit down. Yeah. What is the question? You sit down. Don't make noise, okay? This is a classroom. I am conducting a class for you. Okay.
Hello. Good evening, sir. I'm Gordon from third year mechanical. Yes, sir. My question is, why aging process on space is slower on Earth compared to Earth, sir? Aging process is slower on Earth, space, but aging on Earth is larger, sir.
Well, I personally believe. So, if you go to Mars, okay?
Yes, sir.
Mars, it takes minimum 6 months to reach Mars. With the speed what we are having, the rocket speed what we are having. And suppose you stay some days there, and then you come back. So the Martian years, time is different. Earth time is different. The time difference between the Mars to Sun, Earth to Sun, when the Earth orbits around the Sun, one orbit is equal to
1 year.
Yes. 365 days, you are right, 1 year. Whereas Mars, when it rotates, its time is different. So you have to calculate different time. So there are places you go, you will be 6 years young, 10 years young, 15 years young, it's all possible. Also you can age also, 20 years age possible. Depending upon your orbital situation, with reference to which planet you have gone, okay?
Okay.
Good question. You follow. Yes.
Good evening, sir. Yes. Sir, in the present scenario, can
India become a developed country as told by you in your book, India 2020?
Yeah, very good question. You see, what happened, have you finished your question or you want to ask some more? Only one question. The question is whether India 2020 vision holds good now. Up to 2010, our GDP was growing 9%. Okay, GDP growth, economic growth. Then something, both side of Atlantic Ocean, something happened in economy, crashed, USA, economic crash in Europe, then we got crashed, our economy went to 4.5 to 5% GDP growth. That's what's going on now. I personally believe, if we pick up another year's time, GDP growth, 6 to 8% GDP growth, and maintain it for next few years, definitely India can become an economically developed nation by the year 2020. Apart from that, nowhere in the world, democratic world, we got 600 million youth. Youth power, ignitement of the youth, is the most powerful resource on the earth, above the earth, and under the earth. Okay? Last question, fellow.
Good evening.
Yes, where are you? Yes, last question, you are there?
Yes.
You are the middle, where from you came?
Yes.
That side, you okay.
Good evening, sir.
What are you doing?
I'm studying final year in electrical and electronics engineering, sir.
Okay.
Sir, from your books and speeches, we understand that Dr. Vikram Sarabhai was your visionary. Can you please tell us what are the qualities that we students can imbibe from such a great leader?
Well, I can tell you four qualities. Dr. Vikram Sarabhai are the unique people. I have seen 8 unique people. Okay. Who are the 8 unique people? One is, I have talked to you, Thomas Alva Edison. Another, Alexander Graham Bell. Another, Madame Curie. Another, Wright brothers, two brothers. Then we have Sir C.V. Raman, he discovered the type Y, sea is blue, Y sky is blue. And then Vikram Sarabhai discovered the electrojet phenomena, and he also established space program. So I believe all these people, I have done some research, 4 unique qualities they had. Okay? If you all young guys, boys and girls have acquired, what are the 4 unique qualities? Number one, great aim. You must have small aim. Repeat with me.
Small aim.
It's a crime.
So
all these unique people had great aim. Second one, they continuously acquired the knowledge. Acquired the knowledge through their gurus. Acquired their gurus, real definition of guru. They acquired knowledge through great books. Acquired the knowledge through great human beings. Third, of course, all of you do hard work. Fourth is what's called perseverance. That is, when you do a job, all these unique people, problems will come. But they become the captain of the problem, defeat the problem, and succeed. That's called perseverance. If you have great aim, if you have continuously acquired the knowledge, if you do the hard work, if you do the perseverance, you will become a unique fellow. You will succeed, including Dr. Vikram Sarabhai. Okay? Wish you all the best. God bless you.
Thank you, sir, for having shared your valid thoughts with us. These few moments will last in our hearts forever and ever. Nothing else is very important rather than saying thanks. I would like to take this opportunity to invite Mr. T. Sendil Kumar, HOD, HNS Department, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Your Excellency, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, former President of India, respected dignitaries on the dais, professors, heads of the departments, staff and students. With the blessings of our founder chairman, late Thiru D. Sudarsanam, it is a great pleasure and privilege for me to express a warm and sincere vote of thanks. The best way to predict the future is to create it. Our chief guest is creating the future of India by motivating young citizens of India. And today's event is one among them. And it is one of the significant days for our institution. First of all, on behalf of the management, board of trustees, our director, principal, vice principal, staff and students of S.A. Engineering College, I would like to express our sincere and deep sense of gratitude to His Excellency Bharat Ratna Dr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam for graciously consented to be a part of this occasion and the interaction with our students. Sir, it has been a great honor to have you grace this occasion with your presence. We humbly thank you, sir. When we express our gratitude, we must not forget the highest appreciation is not simply at words, but live by them. Sir, our student will incorporate all your suggestions imparted today, and we will do our best to fulfill your vision. A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step, and I hope that once all our students' signature will become autograph, because our students, all our students will become autograph. It's a big aim. As per your words, small aim is a crime. Because our students, young citizens of India, best brains of the nations, are ignited with your wings of fire, indomitable spirit, and inspiring thoughts. Great hopes make great men. Here we have our trustees. I, from the bottom of my heart, thank the Board of Trustees of Dharmanaidu Educational and Charitable Trust, our Chairman, Thiru D. Duraiswamy, our Vice Chairman, Thiru D. Paranthaman, our Secretary, Thiru D. Dasarathan, Correspondent, Thiru S. Amarnath, Joint Secretary, Thiru S. Gopinath, and Correspondent, Sudarsana Vidyasram, Thiru D. Sabarinath, who have been always with us and share their valuable contribution to the society. Then I would like to express my sincere gratitude to our respected director, Thiru P. Venkatesh Raja, who has been a source of strength and support to all our activities. Further, I express my sincere thanks to our beloved principal, Dr. S. Swayambarhan, and our vice principal, Dr. T. Sasilada, for their guidance. And it gives me immense pleasure to express my thanks to the heads of the departments, professors, all my fellow colleagues, staff members of Sudarsanam Vidyasram, who have worked hard to make this great occasion a grand success. My thanks also go out to guests from other institutions and parents for their presence. I also extend my thanks to all the officials, police officers, media people for their support. A special word of thanks to all the students, young minds of India, for their effective participation. Once again, I thank every one of you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We are at the closure of the event, though closure, that impossible thing that no one had ever experienced in life, because there always seemed to be a little aperture, a slit of light. Let us all raise up for the national anthem.
पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलति तरंगा दव शुभ नामे जाहे दव शुभाशिष माहे गाहे दव शय दादा जनगण मंगल नायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
थैंक्स टू ऑल